Welcome, welcome, welcome. So glad that you all have joined us today. Let me see here.
Oh, you need to take it off of mute?
It's off mute.
Okay. What would you
Okay. Good morning or good afternoon. Well, it's still good morning. We got 1 minute. Welcome, welcome. So glad that all of you have joined us. We got an action-packed training for you all today. So we're going to get started here momentarily. Let me, in the meantime, drop where you are dialing or zooming in from today. Let me see where you're zooming in from. Got a nice on easy background up. Good morning. Okay, West Coast, California. Durham, North Carolina. Let me pull it up a little bit here. Okay, I see Chicago, Florida, High Point, Texas. Okay, see, I'm right here in North Carolina, Charlotte. Charleston, Tuscaloosa, everywhere. Good morning from Mobile, Alabama. Welcome, welcome. I tell you what, and for our family that's over there on the West Coast, thank you. We know we kind of got you up early on a Saturday morning. So hopefully you don't like to sleep in. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So we're going to get started here in about 20 seconds. Keep dropping where you're calling in from or zooming in from. I see Charleston, Las Vegas, okay, Arizona, Nevada. Yes, 9 a.m. I know, Russell. I know, Russell. I know. Morganton, North Carolina. We see you, Millennial Boss. Seattle, okay, Washington. I need to get back there. That's a beautiful place. It's been a few years. Maryland, we see you. Okay, welcome, welcome. Ohio. All right, you're still coming in. New Jersey. Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Okay. Well, welcome you all. Welcome to our Saturday training. I am Tangela Collins Myers, Senior Director, if you don't know who I am. And I'm just excited to be here to share some training with you all. I'm going to be presenting today with one of my dynamic business partners that I'll bring up in just a moment. But we're going to talk to you about getting to director. How many of you heard about getting to director? How many of your success lines have been saying, if you're not a director, you need to get to director? Drop a one in the chat. I want to see how many of you have heard that message, get to director, get to director, get to director. If you haven't heard it, you're hearing me saying it now, get to director. There are some big things that are coming. Myself, as well as my business partner that's going to speak today, we are both on our FAB board with our co-founder, Mr. Chet Seeley, and that's Field Advisory Board. So we're there to advocate not only for ourselves, but for all of you every single week. We meet on Fridays. And so get to director continues to clearly be the message. And so we're going to share some information with you today that should hopefully empower you, inspire you to go ahead and get to director and let us know your success line. No, director is my goal. If director is not where you are today, let them know director is my goal and I come to you because I need you to help me. Okay? That's what we're here for as leaders. We're here to help you realize your dreams, your goals as it relates to this business. But it has to be 51-49, 51% your responsibility, 49% your success line, upline, however you want to call them. It's 49% of theirs. What does that mean, Tangela? That means we cannot want it for you more than you want it for yourself. And so to call your success line and let them know you want to get to director, let them know you're carrying that 51% because you're coming to them with the initial conversation of, I want to get there, help me get there. And so we're going to share with you some information that's going to show you how to get to director. Thank you, Millennial Boss. I see you dropped it. So let me just share this. I probably should have had this up first. Let me just get to the screen because I want y'all to see this. So myself and the dynamic Coach K, I know she's no stranger to none of you, right? You've heard her talk, present. She's an international trainer, but we're going to show you how to get to director today. And I will tell you, this is a not extensive list, but this is the very beginning. And there'll be some other things that you have to build into this, which is called commitment, dedication, bring your leadership to the table, because you don't get to this kind of level by accident. It has to be very intentional. And the intentional part has to be, you have to be ready to level up. So how to get to the director today, we're going to talk to you about your why, your requirements for getting to director, and your strategy. So our goal is to have you walk away from here being ready to now get all the pieces together that you need to go to director if you didn't have those. And so the first part that we're going to talk about is your why. When you think about your why as a director, when you know your why, you'll know your way. Think about that. If you know your why, you'll know your way. That means if you've got it ingrained in you, why you need to achieve this, getting there won't be enough, right? You're going to make that happen. So you're going to put together the plan that you need so you can get there on your way. And so for this first part, I'm going to turn it over to Triple Black Diamond, Karen Wharton, Coach K, as we affectionately call her. Listen, she's a leader. You know, she broke some histories and records when she came into this business, getting to director. But she understood a key driver behind that was her why. So she's going to take you through an exercise that's going to be brilliant. If you didn't know why you was doing this, or your why hasn't kept you grounded enough and it allowed you to get distracted, it won't deep enough, you want to tune in. You want to get a piece of paper. You want to get a pencil. You want to take some copious notes, because she's going to break it down to you how to get to your why. If you're not sure, you know what it is, or maybe it's not deep enough. You're going to see that as well by the information she's going to share with you today. So with that said, I'm going to turn it over to none other than dynamic Triple Black Diamond director, soon to be senior director, Coach K.
Hi, everybody. It is Coach K. I am so glad to have you here today. Listen, let me just tell you something. If you have a dynamic leader like the leader that we have in Dr. Tangela Collins Myers, you cannot go one day without saying, God, I thank you, or Spirit, I thank you, or whoever you thank, you need to thank them, because we have such a dynamic leader, not just only in her, but in the entire leadership staff. I'm talking about with Coach Kev. I'm talking about with Dr. Michelle, and also with Dr. Marlin. We have four outstanding leaders that have been here from the very, very beginning, and we are just blessed that they care enough about us to just ingrain in us. And I can tell you right now, if you have a leader that has been responsive to you, and they have helped train you, and they've taken time out of their building their organization, because listen, we know that this is not one of those things, because in one of those things, people who get to the top can sit there and do nothing. Not here, because we know that this is a real career. We as leaders have to work as well. So when we're taking time out to work with you, that means we're taking time away from building our own organization. So I am just godly grateful for her, godly grateful for the leaders that came before me, godly grateful for these directors that are in this business. Because let me tell you something, it's not easy when you don't have direction. But when you have direction and you have a blueprint, you can do anything. And guys, for those of you who don't understand why we're here, we are here, and this segment is called Discovering Your Why. The reason we are doing that is because there is power behind your goals, and we can see it when your why is not strong enough. Let me tell you something. Just before I got on this call, maybe an hour before, I used to pastor a church called Vision of Christ International Church. And one of my members, one of my ministers passed away. And I found that out about an hour before this call. Now, anybody else or a lot of people would have been like, well, you know, Tangela, you can handle it, do it on your own. But my why is big enough to be here. As much as my heart is, I had to look, wipe my tears, pat that makeup on, and get up on this channel, because I know that my why is bigger than even the pain that I'm in right now. So let's talk about the power behind your why and why it is important for you to don't skip that step. Because a lot of you all are just out here presenting, You're out here in your business, working your business, and you don't even know what your why is. You haven't identified it. Let me explain something. If you have a weak why, you're going to have a weak story, and your story sells. Fact all day will tell people, but people want to connect with who you are. People join you. They don't join this business. So if you can't explain to people who you are and why you're here, then they don't know enough about you to connect with you. A why statement is concise, guys. It's impactful. You articulate your purpose, your vision, your motivation, and your drive for your individual, as you, for you as an individual, and for your organization. When you come in, because everybody doesn't build, and if you don't build, that's quite all right. But if you are a builder, you need to understand what the DNA of your brand is going to look like. What is the DNA of your team? Are you going to have a team that comes in and they're family from the beginning? Listen, when I talk to people and I onboard them, the first thing I want to know is, what are you here for? What are you doing? If they're talking about building, I tell them, start your family from the beginning, because you don't want to come in and be a sole entrepreneur and then expect everybody to support your sole vision. So know whether you want to come in and just be a lone ranger and be an agent, and that's great. But if you want to build a team, find the DNA of your team before you even get started. You can't do that if you don't know your why. It goes beyond the surface level. It delves deeper into reasons for your existence, your engagement, and for your particular endeavor. Why is short for what is hurting you? Why did you come here? Why is this important for you? Why can it help you go from one level to another? But it's also for what is helping you. So if you're hurting when you come, you should be helped in the midst of you growing in this thing. And if you're not, then we need to look at why that is. So let's move forward. If you don't have a sheet of paper and a pen, or if you don't have a way to take notes, get one, because you're going to have an exercise today during this class. So rooted in the purpose, the concept of why is, it answers questions. Why do you do what you do? You need to know that. You don't just need to be here, and you don't even understand why you're here. Some people are here for the money. Some people are here for the community. Some people are here because they're givers. Some people are here because they like analytics. Guess what that ties into? The personality. You know, we had that big personality training done by Dr. Delahousse Clay that was amazing. Let me explain something to you. In order to be a great person in this organization, you have got to operate in all of them. Yes, you will have a dominant trait. I am a flaming red. Everybody knows that. And then my next trait would absolutely be, you know, the green, as far as the emerald, being that person that wants questions answered. And I have that benevolent thing. And the last one is fun, because I'm usually working so much until that's just last on my list. But I know how to tap into them all. Do you know why? Because if you don't know how to operate in them all, you are leaving 25% times each type of personality trait on the table. So if you're good at three of them and you're not good at one, you're leaving 25% there. That means you're only 75% effective. So you want to learn how to engage with all different types and understand how to embed that in your why as well. Guiding values. Values provide a moral compass and define what is most important. Money is not the number one thing. Goal, you know, your title is not the number one thing. You know, how many people you have on your team is not the number one thing. What type of values are you leaving as you are growing? What type of breadcrumbs do you have? Because you know what? Animals are attracted to what they like to eat. So if you put down the type of breadcrumbs that there's no integrity, if you're doing stuff that's not really thought forward, or you're not thinking about other people, guess what? Those are the types of breadcrumbs you leave. So those are the types of people you attract. So make sure that your why has guiding values. What about your motivation and your passions? People are like, oh my goodness, I love when you present. You are so on fire. I'm passionate about what I'm doing. Listen, nobody wants to follow a parked car. This does not have to be
something that is manufactured. I'm really excited about On Easy. I'm really excited about what's coming up. I really love my team and working with my leaders as well as the people that I am leading. I love it. So if I love it, why am I going to come on like Eeyore and sound depressed and look depressed? Even when there are things going wrong, I know that there are things in this organization that people need. That excites me. What is your deeper meaning? It explores the deeper meaning of the impact of your actions. In other words, you're going to have to dig deep for that why, because when you're telling people what your why is, it is so that they can connect with you, so that they know that they're not out there by themselves. They haven't been the only ones that's used up their credit card, and they haven't been the only ones that have a car repossessed. They haven't been the only ones that have been put out of their home. They haven't been the only ones that just did not manage things well when they had an opportunity to. So they need to understand that that was then, but this is now. It should inspire action. Your why should have people saying, you know what? I've been saying for years, I want to get my credit done. I've been saying for years, I want to get a house. However, I did for whatever reason, but now I can look at other people. I can look at Director Farrell and see how he improved his credit. Even, you know, in the midst of what he was going through, I can look at Kiwi, at Director Kiwi, and see that she got her credit pulled up 24 points. I can look at somebody like Director Mead and know that, yeah, she's working a full-time business and she's doing this as well. I can be inspired by those who are doing what it is I need to do to get to the next level. Making you different, it distinguishes you from an individual organization by highlighting what is unique. What's unique about you? Let me tell you something. We are so quick to admire other people, but each and every one of you have unique value. We have a motto on our team, and it is simply this: everybody is somebody. We don't get caught up on titles and things of that nature, but we know we've got some things that are coming down the pipeline. So it's not about the title of director. It is the requirements of director that we are focused on, because you're going to need those requirements to go to the next level. Resilience and perseverance. Let me explain something. Life is going life is going life is going life. Things are going to happen. And if your why can't have you rooted and perseverance and resilience, you will quit. Let me explain something. When you come into a business like this, and you should explain this to people who join you, it takes 9 months, the gestational period, for a child to be born. You are not going to come into a business in the first 30 days and make $1 million, because there are things that you have to grow to. There are things in the business that you've got to develop in. So you cannot go out here and tell people they can get things done and be on you know, on the top of the board in 20 days. Listen, it doesn't work that way. And even if you're there, you don't want to get somewhere and not be able to explain to other people how they can get there, because then you are a team of one. Does this why align with your goals? Does it ensure that your actions are in harmony with the overall purpose? And what communication tool? Communication clears why, your why, and fosters the connection of engagement. Your communication, how you present your why, is going to be vital. And if you hang on to the end, you're going to see how your why connects to something else that has the ability to make you the income that you're here to make, and also connect you to the community that's here. Please don't think of this as just a business. This is a community. Reach out to other people. Understand what their why is. I know what Coach Kev's why is. I know what Dr. Tangela's why is. I know what the people on my team, what their why is. Because guess what? We talk about it about every few months, because your why should evolve with you. Continuous refinement is what will happen. A why statement is not static. It evolves and it gets refined over time. So let's talk about motivation and resilience. When faced with challenges or setbacks, understand this: a strong sense of purpose fuels resilience, helping you bounce back and stay focused on your long-term goals. You got to have purpose in this thing.
you hear a lot of people, not a lot of people, but one thing that I heard the other day that really resonated me was the money is in the mission. It is in the mission. It is not just the finances that you can get. Yes, we all need money to pay our bills and, you know, to take care of things. But I'm going to tell you right now, you've got to have a purpose for being here. And it can't just be money, because that's going to wear off real fast. Are you here to help yourself? Are you here to help other people get into homes? Are you here to help people start businesses, a real business, to get a new career, to find a new path? Are you here to breathe life back into somebody? I had a young man that I was talking to, I was prospecting the other day, and he sent me a picture, and the picture had an empty battery. It was down on red and a full battery. And he simply said, "Thank you so much, because I feel like my battery is full again." What type of change are you making to somebody else? Because if you're only helping you and yours, at the end of the day, only you and yours is going to be able to turn around and help you back. And sometimes you got to step outside of yourself to get what you need. Now, this is what we're going to do, guys. We only have 5 minutes for this. So you're going to start here, but I want somebody to go through as much of this exercise as you can. We're going to make a blanket statement, first of all, of why you got into the business. Why did you come? And I want it to be very high level, to make more money, to help people, to buy a home. I want it to be very, very high level, that very first one. So I want you to take a minute. I'm going to give you a minute to write that down. And put it in the chat, guys. You know where the chat is. Go down to the bottom of the screen. It'll say chat. Type into the chat and just put in there, why are you here? Very short. Don't give me no long sentence. Just like 4 words. To make more money, or 5 words, something very short. Dr. Tangela Collins Myers over here just writing. Listen, we're in training. We're in training. That's right. You don't ever come to training without a pen, without some way to take notes. One of the highest leaders on here, Dr. Kofor, is always taking notes through anybody's training. Doesn't matter what level they're on. And that should tell you, you can learn from anyone. That's why you don't want to get caught up on titles and ranks. You want to get caught up on, what are you leaving? What legacy are you leaving as you're growing to those ranks? Now, again, I want, if you can go through this, and this is going to be something where you're going to have to sit down and really massage this thing. You want to ask yourself 7 times, why is that why your why? Why is that worth it? So let's say your why was, I came here because I need to make money. Why do you need to make money? To pay off debt. So you got to ask yourself every time, why is that important? Why is it important for me to pay off debt? It's important for me to pay off debt because paying off debt gives me freedom. So why is having freedom important? And then you got to come up with something as to why your freedom. I don't want you to be thinking about what anybody else is needing. Right now, I need introspection. I need you to think about what you need for you. So why does paying off debt give me freedom? Why is that important? Because freedom allows me to give to my family, or freedom allows me to spend more time with my family. Why is that important? It's important for me to spend time with my family because in my past, I was on 4 planes a week and I really didn't get to see my family as much as I wanted to because I was trying to provide. So why is it important for you not to do that now? It's important for me not to do that now because I understand that time is my most precious commodity. So this is what I own the most of, what's my most important asset, and I don't want to waste any of it. So why don't you want to waste your time? I don't want to waste my time because I wasted time with other people and they left here and there were things that I needed to pour into them and things they needed to pour into me that would have made me a better person. I didn't get to do that. Do you see how this thing is getting deeper and deeper and deeper? By the time you get to the end of your why, you should be clear on why you came into this business. and why the business is going to change the entire existence of where you are and what you're doing. But it's not just to change you. When I hear the testimonies of why from Coach Kev and from Dr. Kofor and from Dr. Tangela Collins Myers and other leaders, other directors, I get inspired when I hear their why. It makes me want to go harder. It makes me want to work even more, because what I understand is what I do and how I perform in this business doesn't just affect me and my family. It affects those that I have introduced to this business. It affects those that are above me. It affects those that are coming in after me. Notice I did not say those below me, because there's nobody below me. There, though, we have sideline partners in this business. So understand that your why is bigger than you. You got to keep, again, asking yourself why until you get down to that seventh why. When you get down to that seventh one, then we're ready to rock and roll. Guess what it is going to roll into? Your story. Your story is what's going to have people join you. Your story is what's going to tether a stranger to you, tethering them to this business, so then you can build your organization. If you got a weak story, you've got a weak organization. Let me say that again. If you've got a weak story, now we're not telling you to go out here and lie. Please don't, because it's going to come off as unauthentic. You want to be really true to you, because what you may think is not important may be the exact thing somebody else is dealing with. So the last why on line seven, you're going to write your why from that. You're going to write your story from that why, why number seven. So how do you do that? You're going to start off with, who are you? My name is. Tell people who you are. Don't assume people know who you are because you were the next wonder in the last 20 companies you worked in. These individuals don't know who you are. So make sure that you tell people who you are. Number two, what did you do before this? Give me a little bit of background about who you are. Who you are and what you did really shaped not who you are, but who you will become and who you are becoming. So who are you? What did you do before this? What problem did you have? And if you look at a good story, these things are going to be just in there. If you listen to Coach Kev, if you listen to Director Farrell, if you listen to Director Tangela Collins Myers, you're going to hear, who are they? What did they do before this? What problem did they have? The next thing is, what problem did this solve? The ability to come into own easy and work here, the ability to be a mortgage loan originator, the ability to get your credit together, the ability to come in as a realtor and have all your services in one place, the ability to build a brokerage. What problem did this solve? So who are you? What did you do before this? What problem did you have? What problem did this solve? And how has Own Easy changed you for the better? Because even in the very beginning, even if you're new, it had to evoke change in you, and your change will grow. So your change will evolve. But know that these are the things that you need to know. Who are you? What did you do before this? What problem did you have that made you come to this? What problem did this solve, and how has Own Easy changed you for the better? Now, let me tell you the most important thing. 2 minutes or less is not a sermon. It's not a sermon. It's not a sermonette. It's not a prolific dissertation. You're not getting your PhD with this. You want to be able to drop this thing like it's hot. Why? Because you got to roll into the presentation. But you understand how making sure that you get your why together correctly, and you go down to the point where if you really write your why the correct way, your why should make you cry. If your why doesn't make you emotional, if your why doesn't make you really think about, you know, just encompassing everything that got you to this point, it ain't strong enough. And we know that your why is not strong enough when you don't show up for meetings, when you don't show up on calls, when you quit on yourself, when you go into the witness protection program, when you don't show up for training, when you don't train the people that you are bringing in the business. Listen, stop bringing people in here and dropping them off. This is not a daycare center. You bring them in and you plug them in at least. Don't do that. Make sure that your why is going to be strong enough so that when things happen in your life, you can handle those things without quitting your business. Now, we know family first in all things. There are some things that happen in your family. Yes, you got to take a break and take care of that. But your why should tether you to the point where when that thing is done, you are running to come back. Or either you are working a little bit to get back at a time, but you don't just go missing. Because remember, what you do affects the person above you. It affects the person on the same line with you. It affects the people that are coming in after you. You matter. Your why matters. All of this matters. And if your why doesn't, isn't strong enough, it's going to be more difficult for you to attract 56 or 112 people. Now, at this time, guys, I'm going to move out of the way and I'm going to bring up none other than the dynamic, Dr. Tangela Myers Collins. If you don't know who she is, you want to get to know her. She is, if you go to the dictionary and you look up hard worker, you look up loyal, really, you look up skilled, you know, you look up capable. Her picture's going to be right there. I can give you all the accolades about how she's worked for banks for 25 years, how she's a glam mom, you know, how she, you know, supports her friends. I could tell you all that. But sometimes you just got to be in the room to get the fire. She is one of the most integral leaders I've ever met in my life. And this is not edification. This is real. So I'm glad to introduce you to none other than Dr. Tangela Collins Myers.
Wow. Y'all dropped some fire signs in the chat. You know, when Coach K was saying all those things, and all I could do is just say, thank you, Lord. But drop some fire signs in the chat, because I tell you what, she left some nuggets there for you how to get to that why that makes you cry. And I started thinking about mine.
Oh, man.
And we're here together because, listen, we got an in-person event two times after this. So this is that why. That why makes you show up and do some PBRs, right?
Yeah.
But, you know, drop some fire signs in the chat because she just really gave y'all, I think, the key to what's going to change your life. Truly. Like, just knowing what it is inside of you that makes you go do what you do. And so, you know, I'll share with you a little bit, and we're going to jump on into some requirements, but I'm Tangela Collins Myers, Senior Director with this amazing platform. Before I got started with On Easy, I had spent 26 years in corporate America, sometimes working 60 and 70 hours a week, being overworked, underpaid, underpaid, overlooked. Anybody can relate to that. And what I knew while I had rise to the rank of executive leadership, I did not own my time. And that was a problem for me because at the time I had a son that had started having seizures at 9 years old. Mm-hmm. And I realized that if it was going to be up to me to be free, I had to change that. See, I was never going to put myself in a position any longer where I had to decide, do I show up for a meeting because they're expecting me to be there? Or do I show up for a doctor's appointment because my son needs it?
Mm-hmm.
And so that's when I decided to step out into entrepreneurship, going from employee to entrepreneurship, because I needed time, freedom, and flexibility. I needed time to own my own schedule. I needed to be able to take the limits off of my income. Since coming to Own Easy, it allowed me to be able to do that. And even prior to that, it has 6 years ago, I stepped out. I became free. I had time, freedom, and flexibility that I need. Own Easy has allowed me to be able to continue that journey. That's why I do what I do. So Coach K, thank you so very much for that. Because the thing is, when you can get in touch with your why, now you're going to be able to tell people what motivates you and what drives you. But I'm going to leave that alone, because what they say, after the preacher done preach, you don't preach. Listen, she done dropped it. Drop some fire signs in the chat, because I know I'm over here taking notes. Listen, did y'all hear her on that seventh why? That's what you build your story from? Just like I did. Why do I do what I do? Why do you do what you do? And other people need to know why you do what you do as well. And so, again, we talked about how to get the director, your why. Let's talk about director, your requirement. So now that you know your why, you'll know your way.
All right.
Y'all see that?
Right.
So now we're going to talk about the requirements, right? So now that you know why I do what I do, what do I need to do, right? Here are your requirements for director. Path one and path two. There's two paths, if you didn't know, to be able to get to director. But I'm going to tell you my wholehearted sentiments about how to get there. So path one says, I'm going to do this as a team. Path two says, I'm going to do this alone, right? Path two, when you look at the requirements, of course, yes, they are shorter, right? Shorter requirements. It's all about me, myself, and I. But as Coach Karen mentioned, it's about the team. Why do you do what you do? It can't be just about you. It's about the teamwork. When I came over here coming out of corporate America, I knew that I was passionate about helping people be wildly successful. I knew that I was one that was inspiring and sometimes would push that eaglet out the nest because I saw greater in them sometimes than they saw in themselves. And so path one says, you've got to be active and you need to be an advocate, right? So it looks at that requirement. And when you look in the back office, you'll see that requirement. You got to be active. If you're not being active, then you're not plugged in into the business. Then you got to have 500 ranked personal volume. That means, what do I do by myself? And do the math, because I didn't put the math on here. Divide 500 by 90, because every enrollment that we get, it gives us 90 volume points. So 500 divided by 90 will tell you how many you need to personally bring into this business yourself, be it a VIP membership or someone with an MLO advocate enrollment, right? And then $10,000 points in ranked total volume. Ranked total volume means 10,000 as a whole team, together as a team. And then 8 frontline qualified advocates. Let's break this down, because sometimes people may not quite understand this. You may look and you say, you know what? I've enrolled 8 people. Why am I only showing 3 qualified advocates? The only way to be qualified is everyone that you bring into the business, they have to have at least 1 enrollment to be considered qualified. So just think about this. I can have 100 people enrolled as MLO advocates. If they don't have anyone, I don't have any qualified advocates. So 1 enrollment under that person now qualifies them. So I hope that's clear. Drop the 1 in the chat if that cleared it up, if anybody was confused about that. So now when you look and you see, okay, I've got 5 or 8 qualified advocates, but I've got 10 people enrolled, that means somebody don't have 1. The company has given us reporting where we could go in the back office, make a placement view. It's like a org chart view. You're able to clearly see who are all those on my front line, how many of them don't have some. Then those are going to be the ones you want to make sure that you work with to get them qualified. We know 1 is not the goal, but 1 is the start of opening up life insurance, right? But 5 sets them free in terms of their services. 6 promotes them twice. 10 gets a comma check in their back office. I mean, so you got to think about, how do I help encourage this person? How do I help make sure they're clear on what they're missing out on by not continuing to build their business? And then you got to have 2 senior advocate legs. That means you got to have 2 individual people, 2 legs. So 2 legs for me, like, for example, if you have person A and B in the same leg and A and B are senior advocates, both of them, that's still only 1 qualified senior advocate leg. So now you got to go find somebody in those other legs now that can qualify for your senior advocate. So don't get tripped up on that when you look and say, oh, I got 2 senior advocates. But if they're in the same leg of business, that still only counts as 1. So those are the requirements for how to get to director. And then path 2 for how to get to the director is where you do it alone, right? You got to be active. And then you got to do 5,000 personal volume. That means 5,000 worth of volume that you enroll by yourself. Do the math. 5,000 divided by 90. I think that's going to be somewhere in the neighborhood of 56. You got to have now enrolled 50 either members and or business partners by yourself. So you see this graphic over here where it talks about teamwork. is it, do you want to be at the top by yourself or you want to be at the top by the team, by with the team? Uh-huh. And I could tell you in easy, the only way, hear me, to get to the top of this compensation plan in this company is to do it as a team. Because director is the last position that you can get to by yourself. So I understand sometimes you got to do what you got to do. If you are just enrolling, that's fine. But what you need to know, if you are striving for director or you are already at director and you're there alone, you haven't brought your team, that's where your focus needs to be to continue on. You got to bring your team along. And so those are the requirements. And drop some any questions in the chat that you have around that. And then I'm going to talk about this last piece, right? There's your strategy. So we talked about your why, so you get grounded, so you can get that commitment, that dedication, that perseverance, that relentlessness, that motivation. We talked about your requirements. So what does it take? Now we're going to talk about your strategy. And your strategy, I'm going to talk about this, but let me tell you what, I ain't the one that really need to talk about this. The mastermind over here beside me is the one that needs to talk about this, because Coach K created this dynamic 10-10 to win strategy. And it's so simple. And I love her because she deals in process and she deals in simplicity of how do we translate something that could be so simple so people can achieve the results that they want to achieve. And so this 10-10 to win strategy is in your ready, set, launch document that's on the debtcleanseconnect.com app. And so here is the blueprint to go director. Simply put, go ahead and identify and recruit your 10 people and help them recruit their 10 people.
So
finished. And that's director. You thought I had, finish with a $500 bonus. Finish with a comma check in your back pocket, right? And so the key to, it's so simple. I don't know if you thought I was gonna have a strategy any harder than that, but within this strategy to execute on this 10-10 to win means all those other things that you must do. This is the result you're looking for, 10-10 to win. But now you got to make sure, am I prospecting? Am I being a secret advocate of MLO, or am I getting out there, getting visible so people can see me? You got to think about, am I getting people exposed to the information, like getting them on live webinars or sending them pre-recorded videos, inviting them to PBRs? Am I bringing people with me? Am I doing all those things? And so you'll know based off your activity whether you're even enrolled and subscribed to the strategy, right? And then you want to think about, am I now allowing my success line to help me achieve results with closing, the three-way close? Am I moving myself out the way, or am I still doing all the talking? If you're still doing all the talking and you're new and you're struggling with what to say and you look and you're struggling, you don't know why, you don't have people in your business yet, that's why. So I challenge you to do something different. I challenge you to deploy all of these things that we talked about today. I challenge you to really be honest with yourself about where you are. And I just see that there's an E missing, but y'all charge it to my heart, not my head, not my heart. But make sure you challenge yourself to do something different this month than you ever have before. If you've never been consistent, get consistent, because you're going to need to be consistently executing to achieve this strategy, right? And so again, talk to your success line. They want to help you be super successful, but they got to know that you are committed to being able to do this thing. So I'm going to stop my screen share right now and see if there's any questions that anybody have, but it's get to director. Like, that's the goal, lock in. But understanding getting to director is going to answer a lot of your why if you've gone down deep enough. So any questions for anyone? Anyone got any questions? Feel free to drop them in the chat, because this is why we're here. And I'm super excited. We got 130 people on training today. 130 people on training. Get to director. Any questions from anyone? I almost wish that we had this in the other view so we could ask questions. But drop them in the chat if you have any. All right, I see a let's go, let's go. Well, if you're ready to go and you're ready to execute, drop some fire signs in the chat. You ready to go ahead? You ready to go ahead and make sure you got that why clear? so you can get locked and loaded and unstoppable. And when life starts life and telling life to get out your way because you got somewhere to go, drop some fire signs in the chat. If you're ready to go ahead and deploy that the requirements and get clear on that and call your upline, your success line today and say, listen, I'm ready to go. I've been playing with this thing, but I'm not playing no more. Call them today. Let them know. Somebody said, please explain the retention pay. Is it that number four?
Let's see.
Oh, sorry about that, y'all. I'm trying to get back to that question. There was a question. And then we're going to let everybody go. Okay. So it keeps jumping. All right. I can't see it here. So it keeps jumping because the fire signs keep going up. So what I would do, if you want to, just DM me directly, Tangela Collins Myers, and I will get that question answered. It was a question about the retention pay. Said, is 1010 for only new people as it relates to the bonus? So 1010 to win is a strategy for you to get the director, period. How quick you execute 1010 to win will determine whether you will qualify for the accelerator bonuses or not. And so if you hit that bonus at least one time when you initially started, then it resets for you now that you're able to keep hitting it over and over again as long as you do it within the required time frame. But if you by chance missed qualifying the first time around, what you need to know is you still have an opportunity to get compensated a bonus, and that's going to be through helping your other people that you enroll into the business get to accelerate, and you're going to get the sponsor bonus. So I hope that helps. So it's not just for new people, depending on whether you qualified the first time. Let's see what else we got. Where did you say we can find a debt plan to direct? Oh, so you want to go to debtcleanseconnect.com. Somebody drop it in the chat. Debtcleanseconnect.com. And there's going to be PDF, and you're going to see where it says ready, set, launch.
They're beside each other.
Ready, set, and then there's a full just 1010 to win document that's right beside it. And you know, I think about when we go when we used to go to McDonald's, and they used to have a Monopoly board.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. We used to take those pieces off, and we used to put those pieces to look at how close we were. Think about it that way. Put that board somewhere. Every time you clear one of those spots, mark it off so you can visually see. I'm visually like, okay, yep. So this week, because my goal is 10-10 to win every week, I'm still working, but that's okay. So I'm like, okay, I'm at 2 now. I got 8 more to go. I got 8 more before Sunday to clear the 10-10 to win this week. But I see it on a board. Mark it off, because then it's going to push you. When you look and you say, you know what, I got 3 more just to hit this 10-10 to win, and you looking at it, it's just going to motivate you and just inspire you to keep going, keep pushing to get what you got. So hopefully everybody, you see that it's in the chat. Thank you all so much for dropping that debtcleanseconnect.com. Oh, I love that. It says, whisper your why to your significant other. It should impact them.
Yes.
Yes. Listen, bring them along for that vision, whether they in the business or not. Look, your spouse is connected to the accomplishment of the dream. So I can have 120 people, but if not qualified, it doesn't mean anything. That's correct. If you have let me take that back. If you have 120 people directly enrolled by you, then yes, you can hit director. Because remember, path 2 says you have to enroll 5,000, which equates to 56 in enrollment. So if you have 120 personally done by you, yes, you will be director. But if you have 120 and you're trying to look at path one says these people got to have at least one enrollment to be qualified. And not all of them. You only need 8 of them. Mm-hmm. So I hope that helps. Hope that helps. Let's see. I'm scrolling now. I'm trying to thank y'all so much for the love. We appreciate this. If you got value out of this, just drop a house in the chat. We'll give y'all some time to find it. Drop a house. All right, I see somebody, I see some a success line say, let's meet today. Listen, they're ready to go ahead and deploy this strategy. Get to director, get to director, Madeline. Okay, is the 10-10-10, okay, I answered that. Who is the best person to reach out about getting the loan officer program going? I've done their certification. Beverly, reach back to your success line to be able to help you. Reach back to your success line and they can help you guide through that. How do we know who our loan buddy is? Have two clients ready to get pre-approved, have my NMLS. Okay, reach back to your success line and they can help you figure it out because we can help tap into Miss Stephanie, but also look for an email. You need to check your emails because you should have received a welcome email from Capital Federal that told you who your loan buddy is. Sometimes, a lot of times, most times, right? That email will go to spam. So check your spam mail. Yep, check your spam mail. All right, I see some houses in the chat. All right, all right. Yes, I'm director. Yes, speak it, speak it. You got to, listen, you got to see it. That's you got to say it before you see it. Oh. Did you hear me? You got to see it, you got to say it, and you got to see it before you see it. All right, thank you. Okay, awesome. Thank you so much, Wanda. How do I find out how many more members or advocates I need to get to 56? Onika, definitely work with your success line, but you should be able to go into your back office. There is a tab up there that says organization, and you should be able to click on, I look at make a placement because I just like to see the structure. I'm sure there's another way, but work with your success line so you can see, but there's a report in the back office that you can look at to see how many you have and how many more that you need. I'm a director and I have all the requirements to build my family. Yes, thank you, thank you. Well, we were looking forward, Ms. Cole, to that family being built, for sure. All right, any other final questions? Otherwise, me and Coach K gonna get ready to go because we've got to do some PBRs today. When you can't reach success line alternatives. Okay, so if anybody's on the line, Ms. Beverly Brown. Ms. Beverly, who's your direct sponsor? Say what you say till you see what you said. Yes, yeah. I like that, Mr. Farrell.
Yeah.
Say what you saw. Say what you saw till you see what you said. Amen. Please don't go. Okay. Yes. Say what. Okay. Yep. Become a director can make your life better. Absolutely. So you see the directors out here. Drop a D in the chat. Drop a D if you are a director and above out here. Listen, these directors are waiting to pull you up to the next level. We want you to come on up. 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 Pass us. Listen, Disney, I love what we have because it truly is collaboration and not competition. All right, Ms. Michelle, I believe that. I see you. I see you, Queen. I know you are. All right, definitely. All right, so I hope this has been valuable again. Dynamic Coach K. And Handler Collins Myers, as one of the gentlemen on my team calls me Dr. T. I think I'm going to have to adopt that. I like that. It's short. We will see you all later. As always, let us know if you need anything. We hope the training has been super valuable. I know it will be dropped. Oh, you're so welcome. Everyone is so welcome. It will be dropped. And let us know how we can help you support your success. But definitely get with your success line. Remember, 5149. If you don't call your success line, how are they going to know that you really want to get the director? So get to director. Put it in the chat. I am a director. Put it in the chat. I want to see you affirm it. I am a director. I am a director. You welcome, Coach Trills. I am a director. I am a director. Yes, I see it. Come on through. I am a director. See, I'm asking you to do that, not for me.
Yes, sir.
I'm asking you to do that for you because I need you to believe that. And see, the thing is, if we're ever hesitant about writing something or saying something, we don't believe it. I am a director. Put that down because that's for you. I am a director. That's for you. And let me tell you, your success line is watching too. I am a director. They're going to know who we need to make sure we're connected with. Like Sandrea, I see you. I am a director. She's in my business. I see you. I am a director. And many more. Let me tell you, these leaders are watching. So keep dropping. Ms. Denise Wilson, I see you. You are a director. Yes, Mr. Frank Burns, I know. We talked. You are a director. Miss Trills, I know you look going all the way to the top and you're taking a whole lot of people with you. All right, that's our time. We're gone. I love you all. We love you all.
Love you guys.
Thank you so much. But we got to go do this PBR. Talk to y'all soon. Take care.